Hello everyone, today we are going to study chapter number 4, altitude and median of a triangle, practice set number 4, question 1 to question number 4 we are going to complete in today's video. The other question I will be posting it tomorrow. So let's start with the first question from practice set number 4.1. Children, you all can refer the textbook for your questions. Now, in this question, a diagram has already been given to you all. It's a fill in the blank. Okay, so this kind of question can be asked for your MCQs. Now, in this question, they say triangle LMN dash is an altitude. So, we have to name the altitude and dash is the median and the median. So, you can see there are two lines over here. Or you all can say two segments over here, that is LX and LY. So one of this is going to be the altitude and median. So altitude and median we have already done last year. You all can watch that video. The link will be provided in the description box. So in this diagram, the altitude is going to be LX. Okay, so LX is going to be the altitude. You all can write segment LX. Okay, and dash is the median. Now median also we know it divides the segment into two equal parts. So which is going to be it? L and Y. Okay, now I will show you one small trick over here, children, in order to recognize which is altitude and which is median. Now when we have to search for an altitude, it is going to show a 90 degree. Okay, matlab jis line pe 90 degree ka sign hai, that is going to be your altitude. Okay, whereas in the median there is no such sign. Alright, so it is very easy. Keep this trick in your mind and remember it. It will be very easy for you all to find the altitude and median. Now, we have to construct an altitude using an acute angle in the next question. Question is, draw an acute angle triangle PQR. Draw all its altitude. So, we have to draw all the altitudes and name the point of congruence as O. So, let's start first by drawing a triangle. Okay, an acute angle triangle which can be of any measure. Okay, children, so first we will draw a line. Okay, now from this line draw an acute angle. Suppose you all have taken 70 degree. Okay, now from 70 degree draw two segments so that your triangle will be formed. Okay, now your triangle is ready. The name is PQR. Okay, now we have to draw an altitude. Now how you have to draw an altitude? By using a set square. Okay, so anyone you all can use your set square, whichever is comfortable with you. Okay, so first we will draw an altitude using a point Q. So how are you going to draw an altitude using a point Q? So see children, you all have to make an adjustment in such a way, this is your 90 degree of your set square. Okay, so keep on shifting your 90 degree side, that is this side, in such a way until you reach Q. Okay, see, now this line is straight. Okay, this should be over here on this straight line of the 90 degree and your Q should be exactly over here. Got it? So you all have to just make the adjustment in such a way that you get your points. Now this we will name it as S. Alright. Now same thing we will do for the point R. Okay. From this side I will keep on shifting my set square such a way that once I reach R I will stop. Okay. Now I have reached my R. Okay. R is over here and my straight line is also over here. Okay, so I will mark a point over here and draw a altitude. Got it, children? So in this way you all have to draw your altitude. Now we have drawn for Q, R also done. So let's draw for P. Now how are you going to draw for P? It's very easy, children. See, again you all have to use your 90 degree wala side on this side. Okay, and keep on shifting until you get the right angle. Okay, now see, it should be straight on this line and your point should be visible, that is your P point should be visible along with your 90 degree side. Okay, so this should be straight and your P should be visible on this line. Got it? Now I will mark a point over here. Okay, and I will draw it in this way. Okay, now if your diagram is right, you are going to get a point of congruence. Point of congruence means where all the three altitude meets at a point is known as point of congruence. We will name it as O. Okay, so we have forgot to mention this altitude as T, and we will mention this altitude as Q. Q is there. So we will mark this as M. Okay, M is not there. So this altitude is M, MR, QS, PS, and the point of congruence is O. I hope this is easy and understandable. Children, please mention in the comment section if you all have understood this construction. Now we will move on to the next question. Third question is, draw an obtuse angle triangle STV, draw its median and draw the centroid. Now what is an obtuse angle? More than 90 degree. Okay, and we have to draw the medians. Okay, so it is just opposite the altitude as we have drawn. For this we will use a rounder and show the centroid. So wherever the all the three medians are going to meet, that point is known as centroid. First we will draw an acute angle triangle, children. Okay, so for that I will draw an angle of, you can say, 100 degree. Okay, so for that draw a line. We will take an 100 degree. You all can take any measurement, children. You all can take 110, 120, 130, even 91, 95 also you all can take. It should be an obtuse triangle. Okay, so join these points so that your triangle is ready. Name it as S, T and V. Alright, now we have to draw a median. So we have all learned how to draw a median. Median means it is a perpendicular line which divides the segment into two equal parts. It's that simple. Okay, so first we will divide S and V. Okay, so how do we have to draw a perpendicular line in order to get a median? We have to take a distance of more than half. Okay, so this is your distance, more than half. Draw an arc over here. Keep the same distance, draw another arc. Alright, you will get these two points. From these two points, you'll have to mark a X, okay, or a small arcs in order to get, okay, so I have to extend this line again. Alright, now we have got these two points. From these two points, draw your line. Now, why I am drawing a dotted line, you will understand in just a short time, children. For the construction of the perpendicular line, draw a dotted line. Okay, because we have to use these points in order to mark the medians. Okay, so you all have to draw this in a dotted line, or you all can draw a straight line also, no problem. For your understanding, I have drawn a dotted line. You all can draw a straight line also, no problem. Now we have drawn for SV, let's draw for T and V. Same pattern, take distance more than half, draw two arc, take the distance of these two arc, mark the perpendicular line by drawing the intersection of two arcs. Okay, so this point, again I am drawing an dotted line. Okay, so it will be understandable for you all, children, when I explain it. You all can draw a straight line also, no problem. Okay, so here is where I am getting my two point of intersection, but still third one is left. So let's draw the third one by taking distance of more than half. From here also the keep the same distance. Okay, so draw an arc. Alright, so I have got again two points and let's see whether they intersect or no. Yes, they are intersecting at this point only. So again I will draw a dotted line. Again I am saying you all can draw a straight line also, but for your understanding I am drawing a dotted line. Okay, so where is your point of intersection? It's over here. Okay, all the three medians are intersecting outside the point. Outside the triangle, sorry, not point, outside the triangle. But where is the median? We haven't got the median as yet, children. Okay, so for getting the median, what you all have to do? You all have to see from here, where is this point coming over here? See, it's over here. Okay, so for marking the median, this is to be joined. Okay, now you understood why I have drawn a dotted line and a straight line. Now this is your median. Okay, why, where this line was intersecting. Okay, now for V, where is going to be? It's going to be over here. Okay, so join this straight line. Got it? Now this is your midpoint for the vertex V. Now for S, this is going to be, isn't it? Use a scale so that it doesn't get mixed. Yes, it is over there only. So join your S. Because it should not get mixed up, you all have to draw a dotted line, or you all can draw straight line also, no problem. So see, where are the straight lines getting intersected? It is getting, all the three are getting intersected at this point. So this point is known as a centroid. We will name it as O. Got it, children? I hope this is getting clear now. We will mark the medians also, because naming the median is important. So we will name it as M, this median as MV, T, U, okay, not over here, over here. T and U, then S and P. Okay, this point we will name it as P. It's a bit kitschy over here, but you all have to draw it, children. This pattern only, you all have to show it so that it is, the medians are visible, the construction is visible. Okay, you all can watch it again and again so that it will be clear to you all. Let's draw the next one. Fourth question is, draw an obtuse angle, again more than 90 degree wala angle, LMN, draw its altitude. So we have to draw altitude and denote its orthocenter by O. So again we will draw an obtuse angle, children. So let's draw this. Okay, I will again take 100. You all can take any measurement of your choice. So this is my obtuse angle. Name it as LMN. Okay, now we have to draw the altitude, children. Okay, so how are you going to draw the altitude, children? For this, extend this line first. Okay, so this line we will extend. Again, I will show the construction, half into dotted line, which is construction, and the altitude in the straight line so that it will be visible. You all can also do the same, or you all can keep straight line for everything, no problem. Okay, so this, then again I will extend this line also. Okay, so this line I will extend. Using a scale, extend this line also. Okay, so Once you are done with this, you all have to draw an altitude using a set square. So how are you going to draw an altitude using a set square, children? See, this is your 90 degree. This is your 90 degree. So how are you going to place your 90 degree in this way, children? Okay, so that you will get a straight line at its vertex over here, 90 degree wala line on this straight line, and adjust in such a way that L will come. Okay, so you all have to do it by shifting it. Okay, so yes, now my L is also there and my point has also come. Okay, so I will mark this point. Okay, now using an L, I will draw a altitude. Okay, so this is my altitude. I will name it as A. Got it? Now let's draw for N. Now for N, how are you going to shift? So for this, you'll have to use this as your baseline, okay, and keep on shifting until you reach N. Okay, so in this way, yes, now I have used this line also. You will see I have used this line also, and I have reached my N point also, which is over here. Okay, and my 90 is just right over here. Okay, I hope it's visible to you all, children. You all can see. Yes. Now, join this line. Okay, now this is your altitude. And you all have to extend it. Okay, now this line, you all have to extend it so that we will get our orthocenter. Okay, so let's extend this line. Okay, so the extension I will draw in the dotted line, so it will be visible what is median, sorry, what is altitude and what, where we are going to get our orthocenter. Okay, now we have got this line, this altitude also. Now which one is left? On the B point. So how are you going to take? So before drawing for M, we have forgot to extend this altitude, isn't it? So we will extend this altitude. Okay, so don't forget, children, this is your main triangle. LA is your altitude. Okay, MS is your altitude. Now we have to draw for M. Okay, the altitude will be from here. So how are you going to take your altitude, children? So for that, again, your 90 degree, you'll have to shift it in such a way. Okay, so that you will get your point and your line in the straight manner. Okay, so see this. Yes, now it's correct. Okay, you will see we have got your 90 degree on this straight line with the point M. Draw a straight line, not a dotted one, children. Okay, this is your altitude. We will name it as P. You all can name anything, no problem. And now let's extend this line. Okay, now again, extension we will draw in the dotted pattern so that it will be visible. Okay, you will see we have got our orthocenter. Okay, this was your altitude LA, extension. Altitude NS, its extension. And altitude PM and its extension, and both and all the three meet at the point O, which is already been given in the question. We have to mark it as O. Okay, so over here your fourth question is over.